Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. Thanks for being here today. I appreciate you guys, your support so much. Thank you for the donations, the likes, the shares, guys, the beautiful comments. Also, thank you so much for booking readings with me. Yeah, too, if you guys are interested in a personal, or you just want tons of other pick a cards, if this one resonates, check out Patreon, all the information's down below. So let's get a message that you need to know about. What is your next step? Where are you being guided towards? Somebody suggested this on my community post. Where are you being guided towards? So pile one, you're going to choose the card cycles, pile one, pile two, your choice is, ooh, the warrior. Oof, damn. Every time I look at this card, oh my God, tell me I'm wrong. Like, look at that card. I mean, you know, it's been a minute though. In pile three, you're going to choose loyalty. Number 33, loyalty. Okay. So let us find out where you're being guided towards. Okay. So let's see. Holy Spirit, to me in a pile one at this time, please. Pile one. I heard it's who you know. It's who you know. You're being guided somewhere where you're going to be around like a lot of prestigious people. You're going to be rubbing elbows with like rich and fancy people. I'm definitely hearing this is a wealth increase. Like, there is something about the people that you're going to be around are very wealthy, very rich. Okay. Very prominent, like high class society or something. I don't know. You're being guided to like rub elbows with people that are like schmoozing. That's what I heard. Schmoozing, like people that schmooze. I don't know that. I know what it is, but I mean, I don't know why this is happening. Why are you being guided this? Holy Spirit, to me on pile one. Five of Pentacles. Interesting. So this is the card of lack, but like a lot of poverty. I feel like you're about to be introduced to a lot of people who can make your, whoa, honey. They can change your fate. The Magician, bitch. Oh my God. Overnight. These people can change your fate overnight. You could be seeing 555 right now, okay? Oh, ooh. Overnight, they can change your fate. What the fuck? This is powerful. Okay, so something about they really like you. This is, okay. These people are very fancy, okay? You might drive a black SUV. I just saw two black SUVs. That could be important. Your cycle of poverty is over. You're about to meet very well-established people who are rich. It's 4:55 right now. Yeah, exactly. 5:55. You're about to change. And a third black SUV. Okay, listen. You're about to change everything. Okay. But why am I getting that though? Why am I getting that? What am I hearing? The Hierophant. Five. You can't make it up. The Hierophant. People are about to educate you on some things. This is like getting a mentor. This is some sort of, oh God, I feel nauseous all of a sudden. Oh God. I think it scares you. We have 5-5 here. Like, this could really scare you guys. All the magic here, all the black SUVs. I don't think it's not black magic. It's not dark magic. It's good magic. This is you getting out of poverty because you're bringing in very wealthy people. Okay. What are you being readied for? What are you being prepared for? What are you being guided for? Wow. The King of Swords. Very knowledgeable people. They know a lot. Okay. They're very smart, intelligent people. Very logical minded, which is funny because we had the Magician card, and I feel like with you, you're kind of going to be out of your element a little bit. I'm hearing a fish out of water because you, I'm not saying you guys aren't logical. I just feel like if you're watching me, you're probably more in the mystical, metaphysical, magical world, you know, and that's not where you're going. That's not where you're going. You're going, wow. You're going somewhere only a few select people go. Like a VIP group or some shit. Okay, what is this? What is this, Holy Spirit? And why do I have a migraine? Man, in your energy, you have a migraine. The Hermit. Wow. You guys have been preparing for this for a while. You've been in isolation so long. Whoever these people are that you're about to meet, they're really intrigued by you. Like, they're interested in you. Wow. They really like you. There's something so fascinating about your energy. The very fascinating. But it's like you might have that blend of magic and logic that they like. You're a soul searcher, like you searched your soul, and these people, what are you being led towards? Why are you being led towards this? Justice. Ooh, because I heard it's time. It's time. It's time you get your karma, and you have good karma. And this is like, you need people in your corner. What in the heckaroni is going on there? You see that black car? It almost, with tinted windows. Dark, dark windows. Look, there's something about like, this is like a who's who. Like, you're gonna know people. Okay, this is gonna be like a very small group of people that you know, but they're very powerful, very powerful. Oh my God, is this like a coven or something? Shit, I don't know. I don't feel like it's that. I feel like these people are way too logical. No offense. It's just they're not magical. I don't feel like that. Ten of Pentacles. They're wealthy as thick. Very wealthy. Very, very wealthy. Why? Why are you being met with these people? Because I heard that you have karma. Like, you have good karma, right? You might have had somebody stalking you at some point in your life. Like, yeah, you might have felt like people were always out to get you, or people were always watching you, monitoring you. This is like, you're being prepared for a way out of other people's grasp so that you don't have to ever worry about that kind of lifestyle. You can just like be safe and secure on your own financially. There are people coming in to help you financially in some way, like in a big way. What do you do for these people? Ten of Swords. Strength. You help them overcome something painful in their life. Like, you're gonna help them. I feel like you're going to help them realize they've already gone through the Ten of Swords. They've already ended something. They've already ended something in their life. I feel like you help raise these people up a lot. Like, you are fun and lively. You're almost like, I hate to say this, this sounds bad, but I'm getting like a source of entertainment for these people. Not in a bad way or a way that makes you feel like you're selling your soul or selling yourself or anything. It's not anything like that. It's just, you baffle these people, and it's almost interesting. It's almost it's entertaining. I heard it's shock value, something like that. Like, I don't know. It's who you are. You help people realize that they're allowed to be more fun and like loosen up a little bit. Yeah, because I feel like these are very high class society. Like high, this is like prestigious. Okay, they're very prestigious. I feel like these people have a degree. They've got many degrees. What are you being guided towards? What are you being guided towards? Seven of Cups. It's definitely a multitude of people. There's definitely several people. It's not just one. It's like a group. The Fool. I'm really getting, okay. Okay. This is gonna sound horrible. But you know when the king and queen, they bring in like court jesters, like back in the day, people to entertain. Okay, it does sound bad, but I'm kind of getting like you're the jester, like you're a court jester. Oh God, it does. It sounds bad. You're getting ready. You're being guided towards some sort of career where you're entertaining rich and fancy people. I don't know. That's going to be different for everybody, but you're somehow the entertainment value, the shock value, the comic relief, the fun, the, I don't know. You're funny. You're witty. You're charming. You're down to earth. It's down to earth that they love. Okay. Like, even if you're magical, or even if you're like, you know, you're very spiritual, you kind of bring a very practical energy to it, a practicality, and they like that. So these are very rich people. One more on why is this happening? Nine of Cups. I heard you've been through the ringer. You've been through the ringer, and it is time for you to have wish fulfillment. And you're like that. I swear I just saw that car go this way, and then 2 seconds later it comes this way. Okay. You're confusing. You're an enigma. Something about you is, I don't know, people can't put their finger on it. I don't know. People don't understand. And this is like why they want you, like VIP. Like this is why. Like we want to be your friend. We want to have you over. Like we don't understand you, and you're so fun. Yeah. You're so fun and lively and jovial and humorous and yeah. I heard slapstick humor. Something about your humor. It's really adorable. It's really alluring. Like these people really like you. And so the Nine of Cups, you're meant to have wish fulfillment, but you haven't yet. You didn't catch your big break yet. And that's what's about to happen. Basically, it's like you're going to shine, you're going to entertain people. That's what I'm getting. So pile one, the question, what are you being prepared for? You're being prepared for entertaining people. Mm-hmm. Rich, wealthy people. Yeah. Okay. Bye, guys. I hope it helped. Ooh, 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 ooh. Look at that guy, huh? Oh, shit. Man, every time I look at that card. And you know, it shouldn't take an oracle card to do it for you. You know what I mean? Like, my God, it has been way too fucking long. This guy shouldn't do it for me. Lord, but he does. Look at him. Oh, God, it's the eyes. No, it's not. It's the chest. But it's mainly the eyes. It's the everything. Okay. Pile two. I heard pile dos. You might speak Spanish, or you know somebody who speaks Espanol. Your favorite color could be blue. Your eyes could be blue. This person's eyes could be blue. I'm saying this person because, yeah. Well, you're definitely being prepared for a union of sorts. A love partnership. A lovey-dovey partnership. I don't know what fucking timestamp this was. What was it, guys? I don't know. Oh, these fruit flies at this place. Oh, God. I live with a whole bunch of freaking heathens. Roommates that don't take care of their shit. I literally went to go see if I could, like, bake a pizza or bake something in the oven. And I'm so glad I checked before I went grocery shopping. Because as I opened the fucking oven to see if there's even, like, pots and pans or something, there's literally just, like, a dirty pan with a pizza, like, a pizza roller thing. And, like, caked on pizza. From weeks ago. I just don't understand. I don't understand. Anyway, let's get to your reading. Pile two. Ooh, what's this guy saying to me? Ooh, he's saying some things, honey. What is he saying? Ooh, honey, right now he's whispering in my ear. Oh, Lord Jesus. Ten of Cups. Wow. What are you being prepared for? Wow. I love this for you. Ten of Cups is a really good sign. It definitely is a partnership. 100%. Some of you, this could be Five of Wands. Could be that you're being prepared for family, fertility, like to settle down, marry someone. I am getting also, like, if you're already married and you have kids, you're being something about like a family uniting, like Five of Wands, conflict, any conflict in the family, it's being remedied, it's being resolved. Okay, so pile two. All right. Pile two, what you are being guided towards. You are being helped and tasked by spirit with clearing out a lot of family problems or a lot of home life problems. Similar to how I was talking about, like, the house is dirty and whatnot. It's like to get into union, you're starting to realize about commitment, like long-term commitment, long-term stable commitment, family life, the home, stuff like that. You're getting prepared for long-term commitment. That's what you're being readied for right now. Page of Wands. Again, something about children. You might have a kid, or you're getting like your fertility. I heard your fertility dealt with. You're getting your fertility dealt with. Ace of Cups. Yeah, for love. Something about like if you guys have infertility, you might be like healing that. You're probably gonna have children if you don't already. But something about something about your family life is improving, and so is commitment. Your commitment to family life, your commitment to a household, your commitment to being cohabitating with someone. You're gonna be living with somebody if you're not already. And if you are already living with someone, it's a more improved home life. It's more functional. It's more time off. It's the kids acting better, the husband cleaning and the wife cleaning simultaneously kind of thing. It's something about like your home life is going to be improving. Long-term commitment. What is it? This pigeon showed up in pile one and then it shows up here right on the same spot. I don't know. It left and then came back right to the same. The sun. Yeah, definitely children. Definitely children. A family. Oh my God. Six of Cups is literally the family. Okay, yeah. For 100%. 100%. We have the Page of Cups. Okay, you're being prepared for family. Okay? You are going to have a family with, I don't know, hopefully your soulmate. That would be great. If not your soulmate, somebody super sexy. Okay, I don't know. They seem amazing. Okay? This is like, Spirit is preparing you for an avalanche of commitment. And if you've ever been afraid of commitment before, that's why you're being prepared for it, because you have to stop hating commitment. You are supposed to be relied on. You're supposed to be reliable. You're supposed to be responsible. You're supposed to be thinking of others. You are supposed to have a family. That's what pile two is all about. You're going to have a family. Where are you being guided towards? Where are you being guided towards? Eight of Cups, King of Wands, and the Lovers. Exactly. You're healing a lot of pain from ex-boyfriends or ex-girlfriends or whatever. You're healing that so that you can be in a long-term stable commitment, a very loyal commitment. Maybe with a Leo or a Gemini, or you could be one of those signs. Yeah. Long-term. I heard the name Lydia. Lydia? Long-term commitment. Oh, yeah. Six of Wands. Hell yes. So, it looks like to me, King of Cups, it looks like you guys have, you needed to get prepared for this. This isn't something that just shows up for people. Okay? I mean, it does. And oftentimes, love will show up just unannounced. But you don't get to really keep it if you're not prepared for it, right? And so, Spirit is preparing you for it because you're telling the universe that you want it. And so the universe has no choice but to agree that, okay, fine, yeah, all right, sure, yes. You want love? Sure. Yeah, no problem. We love that for you, but it's going to be, you're going to have to go through boot camp. Yeah, you're going through a boot camp. Temperance, yeah. They have to temper your energy. They have to temper you to be in a long-term, fully stable, committed, loyal relationship, okay? Yeah, Ace of Swords, that's the truth. Because, like, before I think you guys thought commitment was kind of boring. You didn't like that. Yeah, no. I get it. Ace of Wands and the Knight of Wands with the Four of Cups. This is like, I don't want commitment. I'm bored with it. I want to have fun, flirt, and have one-night stands kind of thing. So, cool. That phase of your life is over. So pile two, you're done with that lifestyle and you are now about to bring in long-term stable. I heard somebody in that Netflix and chill with. Oh, just like that loyal best friend. Oh my God, my heart. Oh yeah. just somebody you share everything with. Now, again, some of you are already in a commitment, and if that's the case, your home life is just going to improve. It's going to improve because you're doubling down on your ability to provide and be of assistance and heal. So you're being led to a new lifestyle where you're going to be a healer and a giver and a receiver and a lover and a companion and a cleaner and a cook and everything, you know, because it's like this is long-term stable commitment and it's like living with somebody kind of thing. Yeah, that's what I'm getting. All right, guys, I love you. Bye. Ooh. I don't know why I want to say hi. I love your timestamp. That person didn't love me very much. That's okay. That's okay. Ooh, I heard bite it. What the fuck? Okay, pile three. Here's the message. You're kind of being prepared for people that don't like you. Where are you going? Oh my God. Okay. You have been readied. You've been prepared. Where you're being guided to next? Like where you're being led to, where you're being guided. A lot of friction. Okay. We have the loyalty card here. Like a lot of friction, a lot of people that don't like you. But I think what you're going to find soon is that people start changing their mind about you. Yeah. Let's see. Holy Spirit, tune me in. Pile three. I heard clean and sober. Something about like you're going to help people get clean and sober too. That could be a really important message. I heard your testimony is going to get people clean and sober. That's for somebody. I heard the name David. Seven of Swords. Yeah, you're dealing with people who do not like you. I see that clearly. Ooh, Queen of Wands. Wow. Because you're very loud. Your energy is very loud. The sun. Bitch, you are really bright. Yeah, and you are free. You refuse to stop. You refuse to stop. You don't dim your light for anybody. That's what I heard. I don't dim my light for anybody. Got a Scorpio here. Got a. I heard a jealous ex. A jealous ex is watching you. Oh my. Okay. You guys, you were in a really toxic. Okay. A Leo, Scorpio, you are in a really, really toxic something or other, and it could be false twin flame for some of you, but it doesn't matter. If that term doesn't even fucking matter in this instance because it was so toxic that you were being prepared. Okay. Yep. All right. You are being prepared in the wrong relationship so that you can help teach others how to avoid those pitfalls. But also so you can, like, be very combative and aggressive. And, like, you know all the tricks of the devil. Like, what I'm getting is you know all the tricks of the narcissist. Four of Wands. Wow. I literally just said false twin flame, and there's the twin flame card. If you guys do resonate with being a false or had a false twin flame, you are definitely a real twin flame. And soulmate, twin flame, whatever. It doesn't. The point is you had a fake and a fraud in your midst. And you overcame it. You overcame someone from your past. Okay. So what's this about? Where are you being guided to? Where are you heading next? Where's spirit leading you next? Eight of Cups. Yeah, walking away from someone really diabolical, like really deadly, I heard. Ooh, shit. I'm also hearing abusive. Like, what is this? Ooh. The Empress. Ooh, Jesus. You guys, I don't even understand. Like, somebody had you wow, Ten of Wands, completely burdened. You were an Empress the whole time and you were just treated like absolute garbage. And what I'm hearing is you're going to teach people how to stop accepting breadcrumbs. You're being prepared for loyalty to self. You're being guided. Okay? Because you're going to show everybody I'm loyal to self. Me, myself, and I. And to a point where it's actually going to trigger people. Not only are they getting triggered. Stay triggered. Stay triggered. Stay trigger happy. But they're getting a bit irate. Mm-hmm. Yes. But I do feel like a lot of the people that one time hated you are actually like secretly probably obsessed with you. Not, yeah. Nine of Cups. Right. Okay. You guys, there are a lot of people about to surrender to you. Surrender. Surrender. I heard coming in clutch. They're coming in clutch. I don't know if this person plays video games or you do. I'm hearing they're going to surrender. And they're going to be like, okay, you win, fine. Because the pain is too much. Your brightness, you are so bright. You're just radiating positivity. And it's like, ugh, shut up. Shut up already, Pile 3. Like, shut up. My ears hurt. I don't care. And I don't think Pile 3 gives a shit. Pile 3 is going to probably get even louder. And so people are going to surrender to you. And they're going to be like, well, here's the thing. I want the pain to go away. So tell me what to do. Please just like, okay, fine. You win. Like, you win. I'll stop gossiping about you. Or you win. I won't. Oh no, here's a guy riding on a bike that looks like one of my exes. Oh man, that guy was my false twin flame. He showed up at the 222 portal, 22222 in the year 2022. Man, my whole life went to shit after that. Ugh, you know the type. Anyway, this is a very similar situation, and you're about to, what's gonna happen then? Nine of Swords. People are going to confess to you. People are going to confess their sins to you because your life was a struggle. Everything was so painful for you. And people are about to admit, like, I did that. I caused it. I did that. I wished on your downfall. I prayed for you to have a downfall. Nine of Pentacles. And I don't think you're going to be struggling anymore. We have 999 here. This is the end of a cycle. All right. I'm trying to figure out. It's completion, but why? It's because they're in pain. These people are in pain. They're getting their karma. They're getting their just desserts. Karma is coming back to bite these people in the ass. So what's next for you is hearing a lot of people either on the phone, online, in person, whatever, admit to you, grovel to you, beg you for mercy. This is crazy. This is your bad bitch era. This is like your don't fuck with me era. Okay, I need to know more. Spirit, tell me more. Why are they being guided to this? Why is this your next step? Like, your next phase? Tell me more. The Tower, yeah. Oof. Yeah, people's life is going to hell in a handbasket. And they think that if they come back to you, that, like, you'll ease their karma or something. Yeah, if they talk to you, Eight of Wands, that you'll, like, wow, you'll ease up and they won't have such shitty karma. Oh no, that's not how this works. I'm hearing that's not how it. The Star, yeah, no, that's not how it works. They have to go do their own healing, but they are coming to you to say, like, oh yeah, yeah, I did do that. Oh yeah, I gossiped about you. I wanted you to fail. I did do this. So what are you being guided towards? Loyalty to self. In the face of your enemies. In fact, the loyalty to self is so evident that it's going to trigger people. Mm-hmm. A lot. May they be forever fucking triggered. Seven of Cups. What's this? Nervous on how to approach you. There's the fourth nine. Wow. So it's really completion. Okay. So you're being prepared for an avalanche of people confessing and they're in pain and they're coming to you to like relieve that pain. Just be like, bleh, oh my God, here's another guy. I swear to everything. This, oh God. He has the same facial features as the ex I'm telling you about. I'm serious. This is serious business. People are gonna have to come to you to like remove karma. No, 10 of wands, that's not really how it works. I mean, yeah, they might use you as a confessional, like a priest or something. They come to you and they're just like, bleh, word vomiting, but it's not gonna do anything. It's like, okay, thanks. Thank you. Even if you appreciate their apology or something, I feel like pile three already forgave, or it's like you already look past that shit. That's why you're in a higher vibration. So it's like you already did it and they're still this miserable. You already forgave and they're still this miserable. So a confessional really isn't going to change much. I mean, it might help them a little bit feel relieved, but I don't know. I feel like they're going to ask you like, please forgive me. And you're like, I already did. And it's really them. They have to go forgive themselves. Yeah. Okay, so there's got to be something else. Because this didn't feel like the other two piles. This one felt more like very minor. Very minor. What else is going to happen? The Hermit. The Magician. Just kind of like more of the same. I feel like your life is kind of just more of the same. Like exactly as you've been doing, it will continue that way. I just feel like you're doing things fine. Like I don't know how else to say that. You're fine. You didn't dibble and dabble in dark things. Like, you didn't do bad shit. These people did. They really, really hurt you. And if you are wondering why your manifestations didn't come in, this is why. And I feel like them admitting this to you is going to be like, oh, wow. So you did. I knew it. You wanted me to fail the whole fucking time. Judgment. Exactly, bitch. Exactly. Judgment day for these people. It's judgment day for them. And no, you are not going to be in their life anymore. And no. That's why the Hermit is here with the Magician. Like these people, manipulative as hell. And they came in just to play you. And they got played. Player got played. Scorpio, I'm looking at you. Exes from Texas, guys. Don't date anybody from Texas. They think everything's bigger down south. But honey, no. Not everything. The ego is. Not everything else. Oh, Ace of Wands. Oh shit, that's fun. You gotta love it when spirit just likes to have a sense of humor. Look at that, the Ace of Wands, huh? Not that big. Not that grand. Mm-mm. Justice. It is time for karma. It's time that karma gets served. Look at that. 33-33, and you have number 33 here on the card. So, wow. Magic. I feel like this person's going to admit to the fact that they did magic on you. I'm not kidding. Like, this person did spells on you. People in general did spells on you. And they're going to confess. They have to. It's eating them alive. Wheel of Fortune in reverse. I feel like if you guys ever failed, it was this situation. So, you just keep doing you because you're doing it right. And then whoever did it wrong is going to come in saying, I did it wrong and I fucked up your life. Wow. Very cool. Very cool. Guys, I love you. I hope this helped. And if you want a personal with me, all the information is down in the description. I do personal one-on-one coaching if you're interested in spiritual advising as well. I love you guys. I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.